The Self-Made Life Podcast is a podcast for entrepreneurs by entrepreneurs. I'm here to inspire small, local, and creative businesses along their journey to success. I'll share a behind-the-scenes look at what it's like to run and scale a business, branding tips, and I'll also be chatting with other entrepreneurs to share their stories and what it's like to be self-made. All right, so we are back with another episode. This time I'll be interviewing a past client and friend, Kate from Juniper Floral Studio. We are in her new space and it is gorgeous, and we've just kind of taken some measurements to kind of see where we're going to put up some signage and kind of make it their own. So I'm so excited for everything that she's dreaming up in this space, and I can't wait to share more. So without further ado, Kate, why don't you introduce yourself and tell us about you, your business, and how you kind of started Juniper Floral Studios.
Hi, everyone. My name is Kate Jones, and I own Juniper Floral Studio. And thanks for the introduction, Ashley. We started Juniper back in 2018, and it was kind of born out of a need to do something creative, but also through a job loss. I always had a side gig as a florist, working for one of the top 10 florists in Canada, and then from there, I had a full-time job in marketing, working for a food manufacturer, doing food manufacturing marketing across Canada. And unfortunately, that job came to an abrupt end back in June of 2018. And from there, I just decided that the time was right, and I was getting married at the same time, and my future husband sat me down and he just said to me, like, do something you're passionate about, and what does that look like for you? And it really kind of set me on a different journey where I had recruiters reaching out and I had people offering me jobs and positions and these awesome companies with great salaries and everything. But I knew that I was just kind of settling and it wasn't really something that I wanted to be doing. So I then decided, I kind of took a step back and looked at what do I enjoy doing, and do I want to be doing in a full-time role, and Juniper was kind of born from there. So I decided on the floral industry, not knowing a ton about the mechanics behind the scenes of it, and kind of just working my way through that and figuring it out. From there, I decided to reach out to some corporations, one of which was RioCan Centers, and got involved in pop-up shops at their centers. I was working from a studio located in our house, which was really not the best situation, but we made it work, and we held these pop-up shops, and we essentially ran them all across, like, Toronto, like, centers and Oakville Place and Burlington Centre.
Scarborough,
yeah. We were kind of across the map. It worked out really well. We were always located near, like, major subway hubs and things like that. So it did work out quite well for us. From there, the social actually saw one of our pop-up shops and fell in love with our 11 days of tablescaping. During that program, I came up with the idea of partnering with Indigo. So I reached out to Indigo, and Indigo loved us and loved our concept. And so they decided to be a part of it. So we basically just, did this 11 days of tablescaping over the course of majority of November and December at Yonge and Eglinton Centre in Toronto. And from there, the social saw us on CTV, and they brought us onto the show, and they focused on our holiday material, I guess you could say. and really focused it on the show and everything like that. So, and then from there, it kind of spun into wedding season, and 2018 was an awesome year for wedding season. And then unfortunately, the pandemic hit and, weddings kind of died off. And that kind of time, I had found a need for a product, called Spun Textiles, that actually Ashley, worked on all the branding with us on and helped us, kind of create, all of our printed matter and everything for that. And Spun really, was invented during COVID, out of a need for something that I was looking for in the marketplace that didn't currently exist. And we ended up, launching it, during COVID. It really took off, and we knew that we kind of had something special with Spun Textiles. So, and then that's kind of led us into 2021 wedding season. Which has been absolutely crazy. We have accomplished, our team has accomplished over 45 weddings.
Oh my gosh.
We've grown our team to over 10 employees. We're a six-figure business now.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think that's kind of like where we first met, was when I think you were doing a pop-up, and correct me if I'm wrong, I think it was like in Toronto, and you had contacted us when we were still doing like laser cut signage and like stamps, and you needed to come pick up this laser cut Juniper sign and stamp, and it was like so late, and I feel so bad, but I fell asleep, and Tane at the time was coming home from working like an evening shift. And I wrote a note. I was like, this lady's coming to pick up. It's like midnight. Can you run it down? And I guess he saw my phone and she was there. So we ran down with it, saved the day. And then Kate and I later met when I was doing a pop-up, I think, at Maple View Center when I was doing calligraphy. And she came down with Leanne, who does Paper and Lux, which is a paper floral business. And we met there and just kind of been in touch since. And, we helped Kate last year with her rebrand of Juniper Florals. We helped with, the branding for Spun Textiles. So if you don't know Spun Textiles, it is a, luxury hand-dyed silk ribbon line. And, Kate is actually going to be launching, can I tell them?
Yes.
For the winter collection, velvet. Silk velvet ribbon, which is so gorgeous. I just saw some of the samples here today. She's going to be getting them photographed next week, so definitely stay tuned for that. Lots of exciting things coming from Kate and the Juniper Floral Studio team.
Yeah, it's so exciting, and Ashley's worked wonders on all of our.
Okay, I need to take a little break and just share one of our favorite tools, which is HoneyBook. So HoneyBook is our CRM system, and we really can't live without it. We have been using it for the past almost 4 years, and it's been like life-changing in our business. So from leads that kind of filter through our website form, it kind of populates into a new project for us, and seamlessly we can send proposals, we can schedule calls, we can send over invoices, contracts, brochures. And what I love most about it is it's just so easy on the client end, and we are able to get paid quickly and efficiently. And we're able to keep everything together in one easy and simple to use spot. So if you are looking for a client management system, I highly recommend HoneyBook. It has been a total game changer in our business, and I have no doubt that it'll be a total game changer for you too. So if you want to use our exclusive 50% off your first year, you can head over to our website, themonarchdesign.co/resources and click get 50% off HoneyBook and start like utilizing your time better. This thing has literally changed our lives, and I wouldn't be sharing it if I wasn't like raving about it. So definitely give it a try. Let me know what you think. I also wanted to mention they have a setup concierge. So in I think your first like week or so, you're able to work with someone directly in HoneyBook, and they're able to set up everything for you. They're able to set up your contract, all your files, all your services, your pricing, so that literally when you go to send a proposal or invoice, it is so simple. You can also work with workflows, so you can schedule emails, you can put together workflows so that, like, let's say you are working with a wedding client and, you know, you want to send them a questionnaire or timeline schedule for like 2 weeks before their event, you can definitely schedule, send that and put together a workflow so that you're kind of working smarter and not harder. So HoneyBook has done more than just save me time. It helps me to get paid quicker and also look really professional when working with my clients. You know, it's easy for them to get the proposal, get the contract, sign the document, and I'm able to get paid quickly and efficiently. So check out HoneyBook and go over to our website, themonarchdesign.co/resources, and click on the link, get 50% off HoneyBook today.
So I know that like the past couple years, especially with COVID, has been a bit crazy. So why don't you tell us, like, besides like, you know, launching this new business, Spun Textiles, during COVID, what other challenges did you kind of face as a business owner, especially being in the wedding industry over the past 2 years? And how did you kind of like utilize your time to kind of like catapult you into like this season of 2021 weddings?
So I really kind of took the time to like just refresh my branding, with Ashley, of course. So we sourced things like boxes. We got our rebrand done during that time. We really focused on making Spun as good as it could possibly be, so figuring out all the packaging details and things like that. We also took time to get organized, so really to catapult us into like a busy wedding season, we need to like get organized on the back end with all the administration and everything. We create like specific lookbooks for all of our clients, so we really took time to like develop those and get those out to our clients, in most cases ahead of time, but sometimes we were running late.
So a lot of like back end stuff, ironing out the details. You secured this awesome space in downtown Hamilton. You grew your team. And I know, like, I remember before, when I think we did like a shoot at your house with Megan, your mom was on the team.
Yes.
And you had a couple other part-time team members. So can you like walk us through like that process of like, you know, hiring a team and what that kind of looks like now with like running multiple weddings like on weekends? Like how do you do it all?
Yeah, so it's a juggling act. So we have developed a strategy in the studio where we have different like packaging areas, and we have different development areas, and all of the couples' materials for their wedding get put onto like one specific table, and that becomes their station for their wedding. We have team members coming in at different hours, so everyone's got something on our whiteboard where we've written beside the item that needs to be, the task that needs to be done, their actual name and everything. And then from there, they come in, they know what material they're working with, they have the lookbook in hand, and then they just kind of go to work on like their part of the, we call it their piece of the puzzle. So every wedding we look at it as one big puzzle, and then we break it down into smaller chunks on who's doing what. We really take pride in like our quality, so we have a lot of quality assurance standpoints from like just making sure that the materials are all really good from when they first come in, doing all of our prep work ahead of time. So generally we get a shipment of product and then we're prepping it all. So roses need to be dethorned, the leaves need to be removed, the guard petals need to be removed. So all of that's done in-house by our team. It's all very manual labor. from there we just make sure that we're super organized for each couple's day and that we're ready to tackle their wedding. So.
Amazing. Yeah. So it definitely takes a village, and, you know, seeing where you've kind of grown from having like your basement studio and keeping your bathroom downstairs like super cold for like your cold room.
Yes.
To where you are now. It's just been so nice to see your growth, and I just feel so like blessed and honored to kind of be a part of that. And when you worked on your branding, so thank you for, you know, helping or like letting us be a piece of your puzzle. How has like working with us, Monarch Design Co., on your branding helped you with your business and kind of like your client reach?
Yeah. So when I was looking at using like a branding company, Ashley was my first go-to because I absolutely love your style and I love everything you guys do. And from the minute that I like initially met you, like I knew that you had something special that not a lot of companies have. And so I really like, when I was looking at like who was going to do the branding for us, I was like, Ashley, like, is the only go-to person. Like, I just love everything. Like, I love Spun Textiles. I love what you guys now have done with Juniper, but, Juniper needed some help, and my clientele generally is, they're working professionals, they are spending quite a bit of money on like their weddings, and so we really need to be that elevated brand to like match that vision for a bride or our couples. When I was looking again at like who is going to be doing this, I was like, Ashley is my go-to person, and I know she can elevate our brand and take it up 5 levels, and I think you definitely did that. It's been a really great experience, like everything from the branding side of it, like down to like the brand guidelines. Like I love that I can share that with the team and everyone can have that book and they can read through it and they can see like what our colors are and just all of those little details. I think overall it's been really beneficial working with Ashley and with Payne and Monarch. So.
Nice. Yeah, it's definitely like, you know, like with working with a full branding, we really hone in on like who your ideal client is, what your business goals are, where you want to go. And I know like with us being in the wedding industry in the past, we really know like that market really well. So being able to kind of like harness that into the branding for Juniper Florals and then handing them like a neat little package, like here you go, here's all your branding, here's how to use it. It's really helpful with like all this growth that Kate has experienced, because she can kind of like hand off these tasks and these other things that have to do with branding or social media or website, and just know that, you know, it's still consistent and still on brand. Yeah, I think it's awesome just to like see that growth. So what kind of advice would you give someone who's just starting out, maybe in the floral industry or the wedding industry?
Yeah, so I actually get asked this a lot by other wedding professionals, like how did you make it work? And I think like stay true to yourself, stay true to your brand, stay true to what stay true to yourself, stay true to your brand, and stay true to what you offer clients. So we've changed our process a little bit throughout the years, but generally speaking, it's everything's done the same way. So we changed up our ribbons, obviously, to Spun Textiles ribbons, but we make sure that each package going out is as pretty as the last, and we don't compromise on style or anything like that. So we're always using the best quality material. You'll never catch a single stem Ecuador rose in any of our bouquets. I always kind of pride ourselves on that. So garden roses are where we focus our efforts, or like peonies if it's peony season or whatever that looks like seasonality wise. So I think if I had to like offer some advice to people starting out in the floral industry, I would probably recommend that they just do their research, figure out what they want their aesthetic to be, and then stay true to that. So
amazing. Yeah. I know it can be really intimidating, like first starting out, and I mean, I'm sure you know as much as I, like, there's a lot of like mistakes that go into like when you first start a business, and you kind of like learn with like the ebbs and flows, and you kind of like hammer down like your process so that, you know, you're most efficient and you get into that flow. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. Well, I guess I'm in your space today. So thanks for having me in your space today. It was a nice kind of trip down from Barrie, a little bit of a change of scenery. I know that you have your team here and you're getting ready for a weekend wedding.
Yeah.
Weekend wedding. So we will end here, but I will plug all of Kate's details in the show notes and comments or wherever this will live. So make sure to give them a follow and check out their beautiful work. And yeah, stay tuned for the next episode.
Thanks so much, Ashley. It's been a pleasure.
Awesome.